So next is problem 6. 30 gram urea dissolve in 45 gram water. Determine percent weight by weight. Number 2, mole fraction of the urea and water. So first is weight by weight. So according to the definition of percent weight by weight, we required weight of solute and weight of solution. So this is the weight of solvent, this is the weight of solute. You must add these two to get the weight of solution here. So 30 upon 30 plus 45, we will get a 40%. Now for mole fraction, we have to calculate number of moles. Number of moles of urea, 30 upon 60 is the molar mass of urea, so it's 0.5. Number of moles of water, 45 gram water is given, divided by 18 is 2.5. So mole fraction of urea is 0.5. The number of moles of urea divided by total number of moles. Total number of moles is 0.5 plus 2.5. Here we will get 1.6. So if the mole fraction of urea is 1.6, then mole fraction of water will be 5.6, because sum of the mole fraction is always equal to 1. Problem number 7. We have an aqueous solution containing 28% weight by weight of KOH. If the density of solution is 1.25 gram per ml, calculate number 1 mole fraction of KOH, number 2 percentage weight by volume, and number 3 molarity. So let's do percent weight by weight. 28% that is given. So directly you can calculate molarity. X into D into 10 upon MB. This is a direct method to find the molarity when the percentage weight by weight is given, where x is percent, like a 28%. D is a density that is given to 1.25. MB is molar mass of solute, that is KOH. Molar mass of KOH is 56, this 6.3 molar. Percent weight by volume can be calculated by using this relation. Percent weight by weight into D. Weight by weight is 28 into D is 1.25. You can calculate is 35%. Now the next is you have to calculate the mole fraction of KOH, this part. So here 28% weight by weight means 28 gram KOH and 72 gram water. So first find the number of moles. Number of moles of KOH is 0.5. Number of moles of water is 4. So mole fraction of KOH means the number of moles of KOH divided by total number of moles. The number of moles of KOH is 0.5. Total number of moles is 0.5 plus 4. So 4.5 is 1 upon 9. Then problem number 10. Mole fraction of iodine in benzene is 0.2. If density of solution is 1.2 gram per ml, calculate molality, molarity, percent weight by weight, and percent weight by volume. So this is mole fraction of iodine is a solute and benzene is a solvent. So XB is 0.2, that is given. It means XA is 0.8, 1 minus XB. MA, that's the molar mass of solvent, benzene is 78, C6H6. So molarity, the direct relation, molality is XB XA 1000 upon MA. So XB XA is given, MB MA is given. You can calculate the molality, it's approximately 3. Now the conventional method to find the molarity, from molality you can also use the direct relation that we discussed previously. The direct relation between M and which is just complicated, so we will use the conventional method to find out the molarity from the molality. The method is 3 molal, means 3 moles of iodine in 1000 gram of solvent. This is according to the definition. 3 molal means 3 moles of iodine solute in 1000 gram of solvent. So 3 moles of iodine means 3 into 254 gram. This is the mass of solute and this is the mass of solution, solvent. You can calculate the mass of solution, that is 1762 gram. And molarity required, volume of solution, 3 moles, 1762 divided by density, that is given 1.2. So it should become volume in liter in 2000. You can calculate the molarity. Try it. Last is ppm, B category. ppm is amount of solute present in 1 million parts of the solution. That may be a solid state, that may be a liquid state, that weight of solute, weight of solution into 10 to the 6. Weight of volume of solute, volume of solution into 10 to the 6. So 1 ppm is equal to 1 milligram per liter. When 1 milligram of substance is present in 1 liter, that is called 1 ppm. So here is the molarity special cases, very important for MCQ. First case is for dilution, when we add water to some solution, like if we have 200 ml solution, that is 0.2 molar HCl, and we transfer it into a big beaker and add 300 ml water, it means dilution take place. We diluted the solution. So now the total volume become 500. What will be the molarity? To calculate such type of problem, we will use this M1V1 equal to M2V2. This is called molarity equation. M1M2 is for old this solution. M2V2 is for this new one. So what is the molarity of old is 0.2. Volume 200. Molarity of new solution we have to calculate. Volume is 500, so you can calculate M2 easily. This is the first case. Second is for mixing. For mixing means we have to mix up the solutions, 2, 3, 4, means like in this example, we have 100 ml 0.2 molar HCl, 200 ml 0.1 molar HCl, 300 ml 0.3 molar HCl, we mixed 3 solutions in a big beaker, total volume becomes 600, 100 plus 200 plus 300, what will be the molarity? You can use this equation. So this is the equation for the mixing. But for mixing, there must be some conditions. First is, substance should be same, like we are mixing HCl with HCl. Second is, if it is not possible, then at least one ion should be same. Then we can apply that formula M1V1 plus M2V2 and so on. For example, mixing of HCl and NaOH, because they react with each other, this formula cannot be applied. So here is one problem. Last, 200 ml of 0.2 molar NaCl and 300 ml of 0.3 molar NaNO3 are mixed together. Calculate concentration of sodium ion, chloride ion, nitrate ion, molar concentration. So molar concentration of sodium ion, because sodium is present in both. So we will apply the formula for dilution, mixing. Like 0.2 into 200 plus 300 into 0.3 divided by the total volume. You can calculate like this. But chloride ion, simply because chloride ion is present only NaCl. So when you mix these two, just volume will increase. 200 plus 300, 500. So 0.2 molar in 200 divided by 500, you can calculate like this. Similarly, nitrate ion is present only in this. So you simply write 300 into 0.3 divided by 500. So you can calculate like this. Formula will be applied only when some common ion, at least one ion should be same. So that's all. So this is about the concentration terms. So thoroughly listen the video, try the assignments DPP1 and DPP2. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the vapor pressure. Thank you.